Hello everyone, it's Bram Butterham, and welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Age Awakening, Episode 4. In the last episode, we've saved Vigil's keep, we killed the talking darkspawn, the Withered, that was in charge of the attack, and Vigil's keep is now safe again, and we are now in the throne room with Seneschal Varel, Captain of the Guard, Mr. Garavel, and Mistress Woolsey. And in the last episode, we talked to all of them, and they gave us a bunch of new quests. From the main plot, The Righteous Path, Last Legion, The Awakening, and Shadows of the Black March. And I think we will start off with this one, Shadows of the Black March. Because we have to look for Christoph in Amaranthine. And that is a really interesting city. Let's go. Take Anders,
yes,
and Orgrim with us. Because we don't have any others yet.
Blimey, Commander of the Grey. Right. A while back, they caught a thief in the Vigil. Took four wardens to capture him. Gave one of the wardens a black eye, he did. Half joking, they said he might make a good recruit.
Whoa, 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 that was interesting. Anything else?
Should you wish to see him, the recruit, I mean thief, is in the dungeon, sir. I also have some letters, arrived just before you did.
Show them to me.
Just give me a moment.
To me, that always sounded weird. It's like, just give me a moment. As if something really weird happens. Now, this letters for the commander is similar to the Chanter's board in Dragon Age Origins, where you have side quests to get some extra money, and that will all just take extra time to finish. I will take the quest just in case we might stumble upon a couple of the people just along the way. Let's see, Alistair. Or Alistair Anders leveled up. What am I even saying? Now let's see. He is only a spirit healer. I wonder, because he is level 21. He should have his second specialization at level 14. But we only have one specialization point now at level 21. Since we just unlocked the Battle Mage specialization in the last episode, let's go for that, but only to see what new talents this gives. So we are familiar with the Spirit Healer. He has two spell points to assign, that's good. And here is the Battle Mage. The first one, Draining Aura, is a sustained ability. The Battle Mage thrives in the heat of combat, creating a field that drains life energy from nearby enemies to heal the mage for as long as the spell is active. Each time an enemy is drained, spell consumes a small amount of the Battle Mage's mana. Okay. I guess, from reading the description right now, this might be good in combination with a Blood Mage, where a Blood Mage casts spells with his life instead of his mana, or his health. But we have no Blood Mages yet. Hand of Winter. The Battle Mage releases a burst of intense cold, damaging nearby enemies as well as freezing them, unless they pass a physical resistance check. Okay, so this is basically a 360 degree cone of cold, which is awesome, and I don't believe that it affects party members, but I'm not quite sure. Stoic. The Battle Mage has learned to harness his pain, and transform it into power. Restoring mana whenever the mage suffers damage. That is awesome. Elemental Chaos sustained. The Battle Mage creates a field of chaotic swirling energy that continuously harms nearby enemies, dealing damage from each of the elements in turn for as long as the spell is active, but consumes mana rapidly. Okay, so this is an interesting tree. Let's see. But I do think that for now. We don't want to go for Battle Mage, although we might go for this ourselves. But for now, go for Arcane Warrior to give Anders some good armor. Or yeah, let's go for that. Because I was really pleased with how that turned out in Dragon Age Origins. And what can we give him now? He needs level 22 for Master Runecrafting. I think we might save up our skill point for now to give improved clarity as well as improved runecrafting at level 22. Or let's just give him some extra health. What the heck? Actually, no. Combat training, because you don't know that yet. Alrighty, so we have to assign combat magic. Okay. And maybe just go for Arcane Mastery as well. Guess that might be good. Okay. Now for your attribute points. Go for some willpower. Okay, let's give you some armor. So, are you wearing your Juggernaut or Kaelin's armor? I guess Juggernaut. This is backstep damage, mental resistance, dodging attacks, physical resistance. Yeah. Such a shame, but Kaelin's armor is just not good. Why don't we have a bonus yet? Let's destroy these. Let's give him Kaelin's helm, just to give him a helm. What in there? He should get an armor bonus. I don't know what's the problem. Does he have that with Kaelin's armor? Yes. Why not with the Juggernaut then? Plate gloves. All the same. I didn't even know. Okay, let's give him Kaelin's armor then. Looks good on you. Now for Ogryn. I think we want to save his specialization point just for now, because I'm unfamiliar with the talents that come with Guardian or Spirit Warrior. The talent point goes to Second Wind, might be handy, but I think Onslaught is history is really cool, so let's go for a two-handed impact for now. This mode drains stamina constantly. Let's see how much that is. That's not that much. Okay, so let's give him... his tactics. Let's see. Self, any, that's good, but then activate two-handed impact. Self, any, activate berserk. That's cool. Self, any. Use. No, activate mode. Threaten. Then, if an enemy is attacking party member, Anders, use pommel strike. It's good. Disable this. Let's disable this. Save the preset. Alrighty, we are good to go. That again took a bit of time, but it's worth it. Now, why doesn't Ogryn have Helm of the Legion, Gloves of the Legion, Armor of the Legion? He should have a freaking armor bonus. Let's see. Helm of the Legion, Gloves of the Legion, Boots of the Legion, and Armor of the Legion. Yeah, there we go. So unequipping it all. I'm trying that once more with unequip all this. Juggernaut, Juggernaut, Juggernaut. That is weird. The helm shouldn't be one of the required parts. But oh well. We are good to go now. He has disactivated, so we don't need that over here. And now let's see. We have some quests. Statue.
Look at that! Was Andraste really that much of a looker? Don't you think she would have been, I don't know, a barbarian?
It's just a statue.
Sure, but Andraste was a real person once. Before she up and married the Maker, I mean. What would she have thought of the Circle of Magi? Forcing mages to fight demons, or be made tranquil?
I don't know much about human religion.
Seems to me that Andraste counseled men to seek their own path to the Maker, but the Chantry uses her words as a reason to collar us just for being who we are.
I completely agree.
Says the fellow mage. Oh well, she's still quite a looker for a prophet. I'm just saying.
And as a Bruce, it's alright. Now, I think with Sergeant Maverley's, I don't know. You go into the dungeons that this person just spoke of, the private. And I think it's a side quest. I'm not quite sure though. We have to go in here. Why do I have to go in here? Okay. As you might have noticed, I am quite unfamiliar with this game.
You're quite the dirty little mage.
Though it might require a bit more investigating than Dragon Age Origins.
Did we have to come all this way? It's cold here.
Oh, here we have Master Wade and Heron again.
Ah, Warden Commander. I represent Master Wade, the finest
and bloody coldest. I can't feel my fingers.
Finest armorer in Denerim. I thought, well, we thought that you might have need of an armorer.
That is true. Master Wade, I remember you. The Drakeskill armor, right?
My one glittering moment. The highlight of my career. And now I'm stuck at Turnip Keep.
Vigil's Keep. Vigil! Sorry, Warden Commander. You know how he gets.
I sure do. What brings you here?
This is a temporary relocation. The Darkspawn are most active around Amaranthine. We thought we could help.
And I suppose the money the Crown paid us had nothing to do with it?
Shh!
Let me see your shop.
Oh, of course.
Okay. Let's see. Check out sword, long sword, executioner's helm. Ooh, for some extra stamina. Hey, that's not all too bad for us. This is the same, and this is the same. Cool, let's buy that one. Knight Commander's Helm. It's a bit better, but more fatigue as well. Now we have the, oh gosh, Storm Chaser Gauntlets. Let's buy that for any rogue that may join our team. Here we have some more dragon skill armor. Not really interested in that, to be honest. Rain swept. No. Clamshell plate armor. Wow. Dragonbone plate armor. Mage Hunter. Absorbs damage. We might buy that for our future shield person, whoever that might be. Manual of Focus. Ah, cool. Oh, this is awesome. Okay, so first we buy the Manual Guardian as an upgrade, or as an upgrade, as a specialization. Unlock that. And now we buy one Heraldry for the Great Wardens. And here's the Manual of Focus. This tome allows to relocate all her attributes, skills, talents and spells, and specialization. It is destroyed in the reading. Okay, so let's buy four of those. Just in case, I want to have that possibility. Specialization unlock the Guardian. Let's talk with Heren again, because he might provide our other army fellows, I guess, with armor as well.
You're back. You need anything?
My men will need armor.
Providing arms and armor for common soldiers, oh, the indignity.
If we are going to be so dreadfully plebeian, I don't suppose Amaranthine has any proper metal. Silverite? Viridium? Or are we back to bronze weapons? Stone clubs?
Wade has a point. He's happiest and fastest when presented with a challenge. If you come across any deposits of ore, let us know.
Okay, very well.
Come back soon.
Elemental requirements. So if we keep an eye out for element ores, then we should inform Heren about that. Now let's have a look, because
let's get started.
Put some more stuff in the storage that we don't need, namely the Juggernaut armor that's not working. Okay, we can wear the Executioner's helm ourselves if it doesn't look too bad. It does, actually. Well, let's just wear this for now. And let's talk to Zenishal Varel, because the quests apparently...
Commander, the Lords of Amaranthine have come to swear fealty to you and the Grey Wardens. These were Al Rendenhau's vassals. Now they will be yours.
Okay. What do I need to know about them?
Some of these lords bore Rendon no love, but others had their prospects ruined with his demise. Tread carefully, Commander.
Okay.
Lords and ladies, I present the Warden Commander of Ferelden and Isle of Amaranthine.
Commander.
So we still have our Master Coercion, and let's try this Persuade option. Our differences are many, but our cause is one.
Ban Ezmeral of Amaranthine. As is old custom, you have the honor of beginning.
I promise that I, Ban Ezmeral, will be faithful to the Isle in matters of life, limb, and earthly honor. Never will I bear arms against her or her heirs, so I say, in the sight of the Micah.
I promise that I, Lord Edelbreck...
And so the ceremony is complete.
Long live the Warden Commander!
Wait. What just happened? Why do I have the feeling that went too fast? Speak to Senator Vero when you want the ceremony to end. Okay. Let's talk to Sir Tamra.
Warden Commander, we've all heard so much about you. So many good things, unbelievable things. But many of your deeds cost people here a chance at great advancement. So many fortunes were deeply intertwined with the old Arl. Some nobles here, they seek to end your dominion over them.
Are you certain? That's a serious accusation.
I wish I was less certain, sir. I've had occasion to intercept some of their missives. They are cryptic things. Any individual message is unintelligible. But together they form a pattern. They mean to end you before you can begin. A deadly coalition.
A conspiracy to murder me? I'm flattered.
I would take this matter seriously, Warden. They know of your capabilities, and they're spending a fortune to see their aims fulfilled. Given a few days, I can retrieve the messages. I would have brought them tonight, but I didn't know if warning you would be wise. I've much to lose and precious little to gain. Farewell. We will meet again soon.
Okay. So a brewing conspiracy of people who want to murder me. Now let's see, can we talk to all these people?
Honored to meet you, Warden Commander. You come to us during desperate times.
Not more about your precious farms, Edelbreck.
Some in our Arling do not have the comfort of city walls. On the plains, the situation is dire.
Okay, so both in the city of Amaranthine, the situation is dire, but on the plains as well. What seems to be the problem?
As we feast, the peasants on our lands are starving, or worse.
The city's defenses are more important, Edelbreck.
There may be wheat in the silos now, but if the farmers die, where will you get your food?
That is true, actually. I will take the matter under advisement.
Thank you, my liege.
Okay, defending the land. That was it, I guess. Lord Guy. Yeah, let's end the ceremony.
Let me know if you want the nobles cleared out. If you want the ceremony to end, I mean.
Edelbreck said we are not defending the farmlands.
Edelbreck speaks truly, sir, but things are dire. He and Ban Esmeral both contest the deployment of soldiers. But we don't have enough men. It's a matter of what you want to protect. The city, the land, trade.
I leave this to Captain Garavel. Or, actually, we can choose for this ourselves as well. The order stands, the city must be protected. Where Amaranthine has his walls, let the farms have our soldiers. I guess we go for that now. Amaranthine has his walls, let the farms have our soldiers.
As you wish.
Quest completed, and now let's end the ceremony.
Let me know if you want the nobles cleared out. If you want the ceremony to end, I mean.
I have heard of a conspiracy against me.
Do you know the conspirators? The right of high justice is yours, and treachery is a capital offense.
Sir Tamara doesn't know. She's bringing some evidence.
She's a sly one, Sir Tamara, but knowledgeable about such things. Better to be a touch paranoid than turning up face down in a ditch. To proceed, we'd need strong proof, and that'll be hard to gather. There are options, some I would not recommend. They could turn the nobles fierce.
Let them try to trap me. Better men have tried.
Loghain and half the kingdom tried to stop you last time. I suppose there's little to worry about. Anything else?
Yeah, the ceremony has gone long enough, Seneschal.
As you wish, Commander. Clear the hall. The Commander has business to attend to.
Okay. Now, hey, we leveled up. Cool. What has Mistress Woolsey to say?
I'm here to serve, Commander.
Let us see. Can you do anything to resupply our soldiers?
I will do what can be done, but you would be wise to keep alert for trading possibilities in your journeys. If you can persuade any merchants to trade here, it would benefit the Vigil considerably.
Okay, that will be all.
Very well, Commander.
Trade must flow. Okay. We have many more quests now, actually. Let's see. Companions. Prisoner. A man was caught sneaking around the keep before the attack. Since it took 4 Grey Wardens to bring him down, it's clearly no simple thief. Speak to him in the basement dungeon. So that's a companion quest. Maybe it's worth doing that then. Because if he can be a companion, then that's surely interesting, if it's not just about gold. Let's make that active. And let's speak to this woman after we leveled up. Now let's see. We have a specialization point as well. Shapeshifter is as useless as always. Blood mage is always a bit tricky. Battle mage we saw with End is what we want to do. But Keeper surely is interesting as well, since Anders probably won't get another specialization point. I will save this for the next episode, where I am gonna think through how I want to do this, because we bought some tomes that allows us to reallocate or relocate our specialization points, attribute points, and talent points. So maybe I'll just I'll figure that out for the next episode. For now, let's go to this woman, because she is an enchanter. She replaces Sandal.
May I be of service?
Let's do some enchantment.
Of course.
Let's see. So this is what we are wearing right now. Oh, we still have the fire resistant armor. Okay. Oh, but all of our runes got... Oh, that's too bad. Let's give all this to us then. That's too bad, actually, that we lost all of our good... Whatchamacallit? All our good runes. From the last playthrough. Okay, so yeah, with these manuals of focus, we can reallocate our points. And we will do that in the next episode. I will give it some thought on how I want to continue through Dragon Age Awakening compared to Dragon Age Origins. So maybe change up a few things to make it interesting for you to watch and to mix things up a bit compared to Origins. But I hope you enjoyed watching this episode where we took care of some business in Vigil's Keep. We got some quests going, as you can see here, for Vigil's Keep, for the main plot, and for our companions. So there's a lot going on since we are a Warden Commander now. Everyone wants our attention. And in the next episode, we will probably seek out this prisoner. Let's find out who that is, and then go to Amaranthine. But how that will turn out, you'll see in the next episode. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and stay tuned for the next episode to be uploaded soon. Thanks for watching, guys.